Hi there, welcome to another episode of Hackerrank series of challenges. On my screen, I've got the Hackerrank dashboard on the left, Jupyter Notebook on the right that will help me explain things a bit better. So if you're a new viewer, welcome to my channel. And if you're returning, welcome back. Let's go ahead and solve this challenge. This one is about Defaultdict. So Defaultdict is another method from the collections library in Python. And you won't be able to use it unless you import it. Let me quickly run you through why we want to use Defaultdict. So from collections library, import Defaultdict. Once you do this, you will be able to use that. So with normal dictionaries, normally we make them with open and closed bracket. And if I were to make a dictionary of people's first names and last names, like my first name and last name, I can easily say, for Amir, save Charkey. And for John, save Smith. Then when I look at norm dict, you can see that for Amir, we have Charkey, and for John, we have Smith. Could I randomly ask this dictionary something that I haven't shown them? And I can say, can I say, what is Brian's last name? And the dictionary will be like, well, you never told me what is Brian's last name, so you can't really ask me. But the good thing with the default dictionaries is that you can actually make a workaround. It's not gonna guess Brian's last name because it's a computer, it doesn't know what Brian's last name is, but it's not gonna throw an error. So let's make a default dictionary this time and say, this is a default dictionary and the default is a string. So it understands that even though you haven't told me what is Brian's last name, it is a sort of string. So for default dictionary, I can still say, okay, for Amir and for John, the last name is Smith. So happy with those. Show me them. Yep, it's a default dictionary. The default values are a string, and we have the values for Amir and John. But if I said, what is the value for Brian? It will not throw an error. It will say, hey, it's a string, but I don't know. You never told me what it was. So if you haven't seen my video on strings, I've left the link up the top right. Please go ahead and have a look. But this is the idea behind Defaultdict. So I will go ahead and clean up my Jupyter Notebook. What is the task? I have read the task before this video, so I will just make it really simple to understand. It's not really well written in my idea, but the idea is that the user will give us two lists. So one list is called list A or group A, and the other list is called group B or list B. What is our job? It is to go ahead and look at group B or list B and say, give me the first value, which is A in this example. Does A exist in group A? If it does exist, give me the index in the group A. If it doesn't exist, give me value -1. But there is one more thing. Before we accept group A and group B, we will receive their length, which is N and M based on this task. I'll just make my Jupyter Notebook bigger. Our first job is to accept N and M from the user. How do we get it? We need to convert a list based on mapping the integer function onto an input that comes from the user and is split by space. So if you don't know what this means, I've left the link up the top right for you to go ahead and look at my input video. Pause this video here, go check that one out, and come back here. Once you have got N and M from the user, like always, you need to make a container. If user is going to be giving you apples, you need to make a separate container for apples. And then if they're gonna start giving you oranges, you need to make another container for oranges. So I will make one A list, which is an empty list, that's my container. And I will make another one for B, which is another container. Have I received these values of AABB from the user? Not yet. I only know how long they are, which is N and M, and I only have empty containers for them. In order for me to start receiving them, I will start with A. I will say for A in range, and I know that the length is N, for the first list, take your empty container for a list and start appending. Appending means adding to it. What am I adding? Well, whatever the user is giving me. So the user will start giving me using the input function, and I will keep putting it in my container. I will do the same for B, which is of range M. This time I will put it in a separate container, which is called BList, and it will again come from the input function. So this is great. So far, I have received the values and the list from the user. I will need to make a final container that will contain the values that I will be doing magic on them. I will be doing some checking and everything on them. Let's call that a final dictionary and make it a default dict. Remember, this is all about default dict, and it's of the value of string. You don't really have to put it there, but if you wanted, you could do that. But I will not put it there in case there is some integer checking. For now, what I need to do, I need to think about this. The idea is to take one of these from group B, for example, the first one, and check where it lives in group A. This is going to be an interesting one. So I need to write a loop and take items from the B list. That's easy. Then I will need to check if that item lives in the A list. Let's put the word pass here, because if it lives there, if it is there, we have to do some magic and some stuff. For now, hold on to it. But if it is not there, we will print -1. So how do I know that? It says it here. If it does not appear, print -1. So if it does not appear, it's easy. We will print -1. But what if it exists in the first list? I need to be able to return the index that it lives. Because if you look at a list, this is index 0. This is index 1, this is index 2, this is index 3, and this is index 4. There is an index method in Python that you can use and say, where is A in this list? It says, oh, it lives in index 0. Only? No, not only. It is in index 0, in index 1, and index 3. But the problem is, index method only gives you the first time it finds it. And it's not really useful. That's not really what I want. What I really need to do now is to use the enumerate function for index and the value in enumerate of a list. You might be wondering, what is enumerate? I've left the link up the top right for you to understand what does enumerate function do. So what it does, it goes ahead and prints the index against the value. Remember how I said this is 0, this is 1, this is 2? So now it does it for you. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. It is really good. It is really, really useful. And that's all I need, because I want to say, go through the index and the value. If the value equals A, then print the index. Look at that. I got 0, 1, and 3. 0, 1, and 3. So if I was looking for B, I could easily say, where is the index for B? So that's 0, 1. So it's index 2 and index 4. So this is exactly what I want. Now, I'm going to show you how to write this 3 lines in only 1 line. Make a list comprehension. If you don't know what is a list comprehension, I've left the link up the top right. We want to get I for I and X in enumerate of a list if X equals A. Look at that. I received that in a really nice format. Now, I will copy this. Let's clean up after ourselves. Clean up and clean up. Okay. Remember how I put this word pass here for me to come back? This is the time when I will come back. I will paste that one sexy line. Remember, we're not only looking for A, we're looking for any pattern in the B list, which could be A, B, C, whatever is in the B list. So that comes from this if. So I put it here. And I will need to save this into my final container. That's why I made it. So I will say, for this final container, for this key, save this. Now, if I print final dict, you should be able to see. So let's go ahead and do this. I'm just going to replicate whatever is in the example. Where is the example here? So I will enter 5 and 2, and then A, B, A, B, A, and B. Look at that. So I got 0, 1, 3, which was only for A. That was the first round. And this is the very final one. So I received 1, 0, 1, 3, and 2 to 4. What I was expecting was just a bit different. Look, the question says I should receive 1, 2, 4, and 3 and 5. But I only got 0, 1, 3, and 2 and 4. It's because the question adds 1 to every one of them. If I run that again, you will see that with 5 and 2, B, A, B, I will receive 1, 2, 4, and 3 and 5. Look at that. That's exactly the same thing. And now you might say, hey, the appearance of that one looks very different to this one. You are right. You are absolutely right. What I need to do, I need to, one, print every key at its own level. I don't have to repeat that many times. So first time I need to print this. Second time, I need to print this. So I don't need to repeat the first one again. And this will do that. And then the other thing is that I need to join those values using the map function for str onto those values. So if you don't know what the map function does, I will make a video and I will leave the link up the top right. Let's run that again. So 5 and 2, A, A, B, A, B, A, and B. Now, I received exactly what it looks like over there. All I need to do now is first copy this, put it here, and then copy all of this and put it here. Let's submit this code and keep our fingers crossed it will run without any issues. Congratulations, that did run without any issues. But hang on, we need to submit the code to make sure it runs all test cases. Yeah, it did. I hope you really enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, anything is not really clear for you, just leave your questions in the comment area. I am more than happy to help you out. Good luck and thank you.